award. Quit. I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. Hello, tis me again, on my own. Yes, I know, it's Max is having, I don't know what, with someone. He's not cheating, he's on the phone. I know everybody's the same. Everybody's the same. No, not Max. Anyway, it's another one of those Debbie's just gonna chit chat days. I'm on my way to the doctor. Oh Lord, here comes a garbage truck. We have a one lane road, so one of the two of us has got to do something. And I guess it's gonna be me because I'm a whole lot smaller than him. And it's Monday, and they pick up our garbage on Tuesday, so that's interesting. Okay. Sorry. It's going to be crooked. Max laughed hysterically at the one guy that I did where I kept leaving the horn by accident. I don't know. I was having problems that day. It's a beautiful, beautiful sunny day here in Virginia. I don't know what day. It's in November, and it is 64 degrees and sunny, sunny, sunny. I love sun. If I could find a place that was like 60 to, I'll say 80, I'll go through 75, but I'll say 80 degrees year round, and only rained at night. What else? I'd like it there. I really would. Let's see, what do we got going for this week? Max is of course going to the VA today to do his Guitar for Vets volunteer. God, people are gonna kill me today. Mailman, and there's another car, and what was I gonna say? Oh, I forgot. And then tomorrow I play bridge, and then Wednesday the children have invited us to go to the children's museum. They take the kids. Max, he usually takes Thanksgiving week and Christmas and New Year's, kind of that period off, but almost beat the horn. Sorry. Since he got his promotion last year, well, he got it in January of this year, he has been so, so busy, and I got spoiled because he could do everything he had to do in about 6 hours, and we still have time during the day to do things, and not so much anymore. Oh, can you see the earrings? Hi. Hi. Yeah, they're, I don't know, they're at least 5 inches long. Yeah, so I don't know if he's going to get to come to the museum list or not. If not, I will go and meet the kids there. Any chance to see the grandkids. And then Thursday, of course, is Thanksgiving, and the kids are hosting the dinner at their house, and her dad's coming down, and we'll go over, and they get the food from, I don't know, one of those organic places. You know, you get the turkey and the stuffing. South, I'm sorry, it's dressing. It should be made out of cornbread, and it should be out dressing. They like it made out of white bread, and they call it stuffing. My mom was rolling in her grave. And they also, Max always, and I'm like, don't say anything. They get green beans, instead of the old-fashioned green bean casserole with cream and mushroom soup or whatever, they get, I can't think of the word, where you just, not steam them, but where you just throw them in a basket with some water, literally for 5 seconds, and take them back out again, and they crunch like they're raw. They serve those, and I get like 2 and put them on my plate to be played. And Max, every year, gets a serving, and then when he starts chewing them, he says, these aren't done. And I'm like, every year, I'm like, don't get the green beans. You know, you don't like them. But he loves green beans. So, we have the, you know, rolls, pumpkin pie, that kind of stuff. And then beforehand, because they eat late, they eat like 4, 5 at night, and we go over earlier. So they have like assorted cheeses and crackers and fruit and that kind of stuff. I offered for Max to make some deviled eggs if they wanted, and I haven't heard back yet. So he may do that. They all like it except me. I can't stand boiled eggs. They just, I don't know. They don't look right. It's Thursday, and then Friday. Actually, this whole week, I am trying my best to get some eBay stuff done, but not very successfully. Oh, God, this phone's driving me nuts. Something else, too. Santa Debbie wants a new phone for Christmas. She ain't gonna get it, but she wants one. Saturday, Oh, that's what happened. Duh. Saturday, we had a, friend from Louisiana that we hadn't seen since 2006, I think, give us a call. He was in the area, and we met for lunch and walked around downtown Roanoke for a little bit. And you know, you have the family you're born with, can't help that, but then you know, you have the family that you choose. Well, he was, is one of the family I chose to be a son for me. I call him the son of my heart. When Philip left to go to college, I knew he'd never come back to Louisiana. He felt about Louisiana about the way I felt about Louisiana. And he came home for, you know, holidays and stuff like that, but as far as, him coming back to live, knew it was never going to happen. Thought I actually would never get out of there. As bad as it is to say, Hurricane Katrina and Max got me out of Louisiana. Thank God. I hate Hurricane Katrina because it was just devastating. But, I don't have my seatbelt on. I'm like, why is that red light? And that's so unlike me because I'm such a seatbelt person. I always yell at everybody. Oh. This is getting irritating. Should have brought a toothpick to hold this up over here. I'm in a school zone and I'm going to speak. There's a cop up here that's going to get me a ticket. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. So, anyway, he and his partner became like children to us. When we had a gift shop, they had a gift shop too in the same mall, and that's how we met. And oh my God, I just can't tell you. I took them both into my heart, and they took me into their homes and hearts, and it really helped me with not having Philip there, you know, all the time. And they had a in-ground swimming pool, and we were over there probably 4 days a week, because in Louisiana you almost can use it year-round, maybe 10 months. And they would cook dinner and call us, you know, and say, you know, just come on over, don't worry, we cooked for you. And, spaghetti and meatballs used to be my favorite food in the world. I can't eat it anymore because of the gastric bypass. Pasta and me don't get along. So, if I go to an Italian restaurant now, I just order a meatball. And I can't eat much. So it's like, how big are your meatballs? You know, if they're baseball size, I can have one. If they're golf ball size, I can have two. And people look at you strange when you ask these questions. But anyway, They were just wonderful, wonderful boys. And really, really, really hated leaving. Corey, who we met Saturday, his parents are both still living. And his partner's mother had passed away while we actually knew him. And he had a really, really rough time with it. And so he kind of clung to me more, and it really, really devastated him when we left. But I had to get out of there. I really did. I felt horrible. But I don't think, I was talking to Max last night, I don't think I'd be alive right now. We were talking to Corey about, you know, how so-and-so doing, how so-and-so doing, how so-and-so doing. And like 60% of them were dead now. And it was just health issues in Louisiana. And they've got, where we're in Baton Rouge, there's oil refineries and pollutants in the air. And the buildings are like just full of black mold. And they just paint and cover things up. And just asbestos. And I was shocked. I mean, I would say, how's so-and-so? They're dead. You know what I mean? But like I say, I felt bad. In June, my dear, she was my mama. My mom and I never got along, never saw eye to eye. And June was the woman I would have picked to be my mother if I was picking mothers. She just understood me. You know, she just understood that I was who I was, and she didn't try to make me into anybody else. So, I had some good, as I call it, family of the heart. Let me see. I had a red light. I don't want to block. There's a funeral, and I don't want to block the funeral. Somebody's happy at the funeral. Can you hear? Walking out of the funeral line. What else? Oh, yeah, I'm trying to get my eBay store organized. Oh, God bless me for that one. I'm focused. I want to check my free shipping on what I've got free shipping on. I want to check my best offers. See what I've got best offers on. And I got something else. I don't remember. There's three things I'm checking. I printed out the list on Friday and was going to start working on it. And haven't yet. I've got, and I honestly, I've got 600, I think, at 11 listings. And I've started looking at the printout when I did it, and I've got like best offer on things for $12. I'm like, what were you thinking? What happened? You know? So I'm gonna go through and get all those low things off. I don't want best offer on anything less than 40, 50 bucks. That's ridiculous. Anything lower than that. I'm gonna rethink my free shipping on some stuff. I might take it off and then put a sale on it. Raise the price, put a sale on for like 50%, which would wind up being the same thing I would have got if I left the free shipping on. And then I've just got some old stuff that I want to get rid of, and I'm going to go through and just slash that as low as I can. And put that on for 25% off, and hopefully something, you know, works. Yes, I'm adjusting the phone again. I know this is going to be a hard video to watch. Oh, I'm sorry. The wind's probably bothering you, isn't it? Here, I can turn the van on. Yeah, that's better. Going by the Mill Mountain Star, which you can't see. Right there. Big old, what is it? The biggest man-made star in the United States. It's a top of a mountain here, and it shines every night. I don't remember the story of it. I used to know on it used to shine, I think, red, white, and blue. It has something to do maybe with World War II, maybe. And then on 9/11, it went all white for, a couple of weeks, a month or something. Then it went back to red, white, and blue, and they had so many people say they liked the white better. I think it was the war, because it was like honoring veterans and stuff like that, and the 9/11 people that wanted it left white, so now it's just solid white. I have to take you up there sometime and show you a beautiful view of Roanoke from up there. It's right off the Blue Ridge Park, right? It's Turner's right there. A lot of people have their wedding pictures made up there within the background and the skyline and everything. It's nice. What else was I talking about? One of the grandkids' birthday was last Wednesday. And so Thanksgiving, he gets his birthday presents, but of course we had to get something for the non-birthday child so that there wouldn't be a hissy fit. My mother used to say that. I have no idea what a hissy is. Does anybody know what a hissy is? Hissy having a fit? I don't know. But I was talking to my son, and he said the gifts that the birthday boy got, the other one kind of watched, and as soon as he put one down, he leaped on it and took it, hit it, and he kept doing that. And then when the birthday boy went and tried to get it back, the other boy went, mine! He's learned that real well. Everything's his. So, Yaya talks to him about it, though. This me. I explained to him that he has to share, or Yaya will take all of his toys away and take them to her house. He doesn't like that. So he shares. I know. I'm a bush, though. Probably when he gets, what do you think? I don't know, 6 or 8, he's going to figure out, Yaya ain't going to do that. Stop behaving. But, they're the joy of our lives. That's another reason we...
That God bless the broken road that led me straight to you.